Hi, welcome back to Wesbury 101. I'm Brian Wesbury, Chief Economist at First Trust Portfolios. Remember, we want to be the antidote to conventional wisdom. But one of the great things of having tens of thousands of financial advisors in touch with us and their millions of clients, in essence, through them, is that we hear what's on investors' minds pretty quickly. And one of the biggest questions, most asked questions of the last couple of weeks has been, is all this political noise we have out there going to affect the economy and stocks? My quick answer here, and then I'll explain it, is that we have to separate politics from policy. And right now, policy suggests to me that that's good news for the economy and stocks in the future. In other words, put this noise aside and stay invested. But let's talk about the politics real quickly. We clearly have an unconventional president. Some people call him unpresidential. I'll use the word unconventional. He tweets, he attacks, he's on the fight all the time. And who he's fighting with is the press and Congress. So let's look at them for just a second. You know, Congress, 8 years into an economic recovery, the United States is in a $700 billion deficit. And in fact, no forecast has a surplus anywhere in sight. In fact, trillion-dollar deficits as far as the eye can see. In other words, I would argue Congress has failed at its job. The last time we were 8 years into a recovery, we had a surplus in the federal budget. The press, I don't know whether it's 60% or 70% or more, but they seem adamant about fighting the president every step of the way. And as a result, I think with Congress failing at its job and much of the press attacking the president, an unconventional president is what we get. He's angry with both of these groups. They're angry with him. And as a result, they deserve each other. In effect, they're going to continue to fight. And I would argue as an investor, you need to put that noise aside, because what really matters is policy and beyond that, entrepreneurship and innovation. So let's take a quick look at policy. You know, there's really four threats to our prosperity. Monetary policy is number one. Right now, the Fed is tightening so slowly, I'm not worried about that. Trade protection is the second threat, and it's a big threat. The Smoot-Hawley Tariff Act and the Great Depression was not good. And this president talked about putting tariffs in place, but it looks like the free traders in the White House have won. And in fact, I believe the odds of a trade war have shrunk to extremely, extremely low levels. Number three is taxes. If tax rates are hiked, that's not good for the economy. But right now, Congress is talking about both tax reform and tax cuts. I expect that we see something along those lines in the next 9 to 12 months. Tax hikes are off the table. Spending and regulation. Spending right now has not been cut in any dramatic way. However, because of the hiring freeze that President Trump put in place, we've had a complete shift in the direction of federal government employment. From January to July of 2017, federal government employment is down 7,000 jobs. January to July of 2016, last year, government employment was up 31,000 jobs. In 2015, during that same time period, federal government employment was up 12,000. So we have had a change in the direction of federal government employment. That's really good. Regulation is actually moving in a very positive direction. We have rolled back some regulations, very hard to figure out exactly how many. But the best news is that we aren't adding any new ones. And what these two things will do, a shrinking in the size of the federal government and a rollback of regulations, is help entrepreneurship. Which, you know, people that frack wells, engineers that write new code or design new computer chips or crack biotechnicians that crack the genetic code, they don't care what's on CNN or MSNBC or Fox News. They're going into work and finding better ways and more efficient ways to do things. And that's what drives the economy. So guess what? You can put that political gamesmanship aside and focus on the entrepreneurship and the better policies that we have. Separate your politics from your policy, your politics from the investing world, and you can be a much more happy investor. Stay invested and ignore the noise. Thanks so much for visiting Wesbury 101. We'll see you next time.